Welcome to the BioBalance HealthCast, episode number 433, Obesity and Vitamin D Deficiency.
BioBalance HealthCast features conversations about positive aging. Your hosts are Dr. Kathy Maupin, Medical Director of BioBalance Health and a leading expert in treating symptoms of aging, and Brett Newcomb, a licensed professional counselor. Dr. Maupin and Brett are the authors of The Secret Female Hormone, the seminal work about hormone replacement therapy for women, which is available on Amazon or from Dr. Maupin's office at BioBalance Health. Dr. Maupin's office is currently accepting new patients.
We are in Mexico, in the sun, filming this podcast. And in doing that, we're violating a lot of the lessons that we have been taught by dermatologists in the United States and by people that are worried, legitimately worried, concerned about skin cancers and the damage that they can do to your health. But as a result of those concerns, the pendulum has swung too far in the other direction. We need vitamin D. The best way that we can get it is to absorb it from being out in the open air and the sunshine. If we're not out in the open air enough to get the vitamin D that we need, then we have to supplement our diets with vitamin D. And we have to do that because the absence of vitamin D at adequate levels in our system helps us to become obese and diabetic, and it can ultimately lead to our deaths. And so we're going to talk about vitamins today and the role that they play in good health. And so I want to ask you, first of all, when people get concerned about, you know, vitamins and multivitamins and take all these things, I've read that some doctors will tell a young mother that multivitamins are the most expensive form of urine that you can get out of your kid, because they don't do anything. They don't need those. And other people are so absorbed.
Children actually need them even more than we do, because if you've had a child, you know that they don't eat everything.
Right.
They don't eat everything that they should eat. They don't may not like salad. They may not like beans or peas or something that's green. Therefore, they are not getting all the vitamins that they need. So it is very important to give your child multivitamins. And if it is expensive urine, that just means that you use what you need and then the rest goes out in your urine.
Yeah.
And that is true for water-soluble vitamins.
Okay.
So that's like the B's and the C's. They're water-soluble and they will not collect in the body.
Okay. Which
is a good thing.
Yeah.
So that's our safety valve, is we get rid of what we don't need in the urine. So I love multivitamins. I like chewable multivitamins for both adults and children. And I think that that's very important to augment our diet. One of the things that's happened over the last 100 years is that our food is not as nutritious as it used to be.
Mm-hmm.
We don't have as much vitamins or any kind of nutrients in apples, oranges, fresh food, but most of us don't eat fresh food.
And as a culture, we don't eat fresh foods. We eat prepared foods. And a lot of the nutrients have been stripped out of those through the preparation process. Like white bread is a really good example.
Mm-hmm.
People that eat white bread are getting nothing but filler.
Right. Or maybe a little fiber, but they're getting a lot of calories and they're getting a lot of sugar, blood sugar.
And not nutrients and not vitamins.
So I think it's really important for us to consider vitamins not as people who are, like, I take a ton of vitamins and supplements, but they're all for something. And our patients actually take a supplement for each problem that they have, and they know which problems, or they should know, because we'd explain
it. You explain it to them, exactly.
Which problem they're taking each vitamin for, but I also suggest a multivitamin to just kind of cover everything else. Now, today we're talking about being obese and vitamin D.
Right.
And vitamin D is not water soluble. So it is important how much vitamin D you take. A, E, and D are all fat solubles. So they are fat soluble vitamins that are stored in our fat. And if we take too much, often we will then have too much of an effect. We can't get rid of them as easily. But the problem with obesity is that we don't have enough vitamin D to actually make our metabolism work. It is one of the vitamins that's really a hormone. And that hormone makes our pancreas work, gives us insulin, helps us prevent diabetes, helps us prevent obesity.
That specific vitamin D.
Yeah.
Right.
So vitamin D is really necessary for us. And if we don't get it from the sun, we don't get it from our nutrients. We rarely drink vitamin D milk anymore. There's not a lot of supplementation of vitamin D in our diets.
Our diet, right.
So my advice, if you live anywhere, we're in Mexico now. So if you live anywhere in the northern United States from the, what parallel are we 30, on in St.
38.
Louis? 38th parallel and above, and even a little bit below that, you should be taking vitamin D, even if you work outside, because you can only work outside 6 months of the year.
I don't know.
And get enough sunshine.
So we did a podcast recently, maybe you've seen it, about the seasonal affective disorder. And one of the contributors to that is the absence of enough sunlight. Mm-hmm. And so a treatment for that that is recommended is to get out in the sunlight or get sun lamps mm-hmm. that you can get 30 minutes a day of exposure to your skin.
Spectrum light.
Yes, a full spectrum
light.
Specialty lamp that mm-hmm. you can get. But still the recommendation is for maximum impact is get outside 30 minutes a day mm-hmm. if you can, wherever you live, but without completely covering your body, fabric from the sun, or slathering yourself with sunscreen
right.
so that the rays can't come through.
So the other caveat is if you have light skin, and you're more prone to burning. Burning is not good for your skin, obviously.
Oh, absolutely. And never burn.
So a half an hour may be all you can tolerate, but that's enough to get enough vitamin D into your body. Then you can put your sunscreen
on. Yeah, we're not talking about tanning. I mean, some people have a real resistance to that, and it may be an overreaction to the concept, but just getting natural sunlight uh-huh. is the best thing that you can do. If you can't do that or won't do that, then you need to take a vitamin D supplement.
And the darker your skin, the harder it is for you to absorb vitamin D. So if you have black skin or tan skin like I have, then you need more hours or more minutes under the sun to actually absorb enough vitamin D. The lighter you are, the faster you get it, but also the faster you burn.
Right.
So it's kind of an interesting thing. So if you have dark skin, you can stay out longer without sunscreen, but you have to use it after that.
So cultures ebb and flow. And this concept about vitamins in the appropriate amounts, the appropriate kinds of vitamins, is not a new concept. In the 1800s, there was an issue worldwide with the lack of adequate amounts of vitamin C. And most of that comes in our diet from citrus-related
fruits.
And an example, in the age of sail, they estimated that 50% of sailors would die on a long voyage. A long voyage would be 3 to 5 years at sea, try to sail around the world. And they would, because they would develop something called scurvy from a lack of adequate vitamin C. Mm-hmm. And there was a doctor in England that figured out that you could get the vitamin C that you needed from limes and citrus
right.
fruits. And so the English Navy began to issue a lime ration along with the grog ration that it gave its sailors.
But they could get their limes because they were in the Navy and bring them back from a warmer climb.
And so they were on shipboard. But scurvy caused all of these deformities, bone brittleness, mm-hmm. Open wounds.
Bleeding. Bleeding gums.
Teeth loss.
And anemia.
And would eventually kill you if it was not treated.
It would kill you just from that one vitamin being deficient.
Yes. And so we call them limeys because they all took limes with them on ocean voyages to stop having scurvy. Now, in today's world, we have lots of vitamin C available because it's a supplement that we can put in the food. It's a vitamin that we can take independently.
And we actually eat a lot of
fruit. We have access to a lot of fresh fruits and citrus.
Because of transportation?
Fresh and frozen. Mm-hmm. We have a transportation system that will provide them so we can get them if we want to drink a glass of orange juice, drink some lemonade, mm-hmm. some limeade, whatever you might want.
And
we have that option.
And that's vitamin C, and it's a water-soluble vitamin, so you don't store it up.
Uh-huh.
You couldn't have enough vitamin C and then say, I'm not going to use it, I'm not going to take it anymore, because vitamin C goes right out your kidneys if you have too much.
Right.
So you really can't eat
can't
too
hold
much,
it and, save it.
And you can't save it.
Right.
So you have to have it daily.
So then today's world, different vitamin, same concept. If we are undernourished, even if in an age of abundance where we have a lot of food, so many people eat the wrong foods. And one of the obesity issues in our country is particularly impacting poor folks, because poor folks don't spend their few dollars on the most nutritious food. They spend it on bulk food,
mm-hmm.
things that they can eat that will fill their stomachs mm-hmm. and tend to make them fatter, because it's almost all carbs.
In the U.S.,
salt, at least
food
in the United
stamps
States.
Gives you food stamps for
right.
fruit.
Yes.
So.
They can make those choices,
it.
But they're not
so,
necessarily educated
I mean, at least we're
to make
trying.
Those choices.
And
they don't have that opportunity, a lot of them. But even people who do have the opportunity and are better educated still eat inappropriately, and they get caught in this perfect storm of becoming obese, but in part because they don't get enough vitamin D, but the more obese they are, the less vitamin D they can process, right, which makes them fatter, which makes less vitamin D, and it just is, spirals out of control. You get to obesity, you get to diabetes, you get other things that come from that trigger point. So you need to work on trying to find balance.
Well, and you know, it's kind of like which comes first, the chicken or the egg. Do I lose weight first? Do I take vitamin D and get out in the sun first?
Right.
I have one comment on people who may not have as much money in our country, mm-hmm, and obviously we know that white folks are at the top.
Right.
But the darker your skin, the more you need vitamin D. So that is very important, and that's where we kind of fall apart, because we don't say that to people. We don't say you need more. I always thought, before I did anti-aging medicine, that I was dark skin, so I'd get more vitamin D.
Right.
But it's untrue. So you have to be out in the sun longer if you have dark skin, or you have to take more.
Because of the coloration in the skin?
It protects you.
Yeah.
It protects you from cancer of the skin, but right, it also, not always.
Non-white people have fewer skin cancers.
Yeah.
Yes.
So basically it protects you from it.
And the closer to the equator you live, fewer skin cancers.
Right. So, yeah, and usually that means that God gave you darker skin so you wouldn't get burned all the time.
Yeah.
So that's a protection, but vitamin D should be supplemented. The more dark skin and the heavier you are.
So put on your gynecologist hat.
Yes.
For a minute. Two of the side effects that we're concerned about with too low amounts of vitamin D are preterm labor issues, mm-hmm, and
gestational diabetes.
So can you talk about both of those?
Well, they've always been a little. Well, let me go through. Preterm labor has to do with a lot of things. It can have to do with rupture of the membranes where the bag breaks, that starts labor, and an infection then occurs. Sometimes if you have a lot of inflammation, and vitamin D helps with inflammation and decreases it, then that increases preterm labor. There's a lot of reasons for preterm labor, but vitamin D is one of them. We get prenatal vitamins, and we haven't been given enough D in the prenatal vitamins.
So the prenatal vitamin protects the baby, not so much the mother.
Both. Okay. It replaces. You see, when you're pregnant, you take all of your nutrition out of your body and give it to your baby.
Okay.
So if you don't have enough.
You breathe for them, your heart beats for them, everything.
And all your nutrition. I mean, people can get osteoporotic if they don't take enough vitamin D and calcium while they're pregnant, because all of that, the hormones of pregnancy pull all that calcium for the baby. Then if you don't have enough vitamin D or calcium,
uh-huh,
then you're left without it, but the vitamins give it to you back.
Okay,
we try to give it back with the prenatal vitamin. So it's both.
So then what's gestational diabetes?
Gestational diabetes is a high blood sugar with pregnancy. So some of the pregnancy hormones and the growth hormones of the baby can cause you to have a diabetic type picture.
Okay.
And it goes away when you're done being pregnant.
So I don't know this stuff. I want to ask.
So it's a high blood sugar.
How does that connect to fetal alcohol syndrome? If a pregnant woman is drinking alcohol, is this related to that?
No.
Or something totally different?
Totally different.
Okay.
So blood sugar is basically it increases the size of your baby. You can have a huge baby, 10, 11 pounds is a huge baby.
Yeah.
Have a hard time delivering, and you also gain more weight when you have gestational diabetes. So you get obese, and you have obesity problems when you're done being pregnant,
mm-hmm,
when the baby that was taking your calories is gone. So it gives you lots of problems, but it's an indicator that you'll get type 2 diabetes, which is obesity related diabetes later in your life. That's one of the biggest risk factors for adult onset diabetes.
So we were talking about this whole concept of vitamin D and where we live in the Midwest part of the United, mm-hmm, States, and you segued into another discussion that we've done a different podcast on, which is that we live in an iodine sink.
Yeah.
And is iodine related to vitamin D, or is that just another dietary deficiency?
It's another dietary deficiency. I think it's important to look at what your environment is. If your environment is north, then you need more vitamin C than if you live in Florida or Mexico, or someplace else that's Southern California.
D.
I'm taught D.
D.
Yeah. So that's sun.
Right.
So you have to look at that. Then you have to look at your diet. But part of that where do you live thing,
mm-hmm,
is, do you have iodine in your environment. So we're right by the ocean. So by walking on the beach, you absorb iodine from the beach. That's from the kelp that's in the sea, gets micronized and goes out into the air, and then you absorb it through your skin.
Same way you do vitamin D.
Right, but it's different. That's sun.
Yeah.
It's a whole different process, but it is through your skin.
Okay.
So if you live on the ocean, you're getting enough iodine. If you live in a place where an ocean used to be, which is a lot of the United States, it's in the soil,
right,
then your water and your food that grows locally will have iodine.
Right.
But if you live in the Midwest, all the way up through Canada, there was no ocean for many millennia, and there's no iodine in the soil. Or water. It's gone. It didn't really develop.
So there's a supplement, Iodorol?
Iodorol is what we give to people to make up for that. So almost everyone who comes to my office in the Midwest and Kansas City and St. Louis get vitamin D and Iodorol because of where we live, not because of a blood level. Checking blood levels of vitamin D is really expensive right now.
Mm-hmm.
So we try to limit that, and we know that if you, if you don't spend half your life in the South, then in the sun,
right,
then you're, or if you have sunscreen on all the time.
Most of us don't work outside or play outside
anymore
all that much. You know, we get in the car and drive to the gym and work out and then drive back home. We're not outside working out
as a global element of our society.
Yeah, and we work inside.
And more and more that's happening. And kids are even more inside more because of video games and TV.
Yeah.
So we've progressed ourselves into a problem where we're not outside as much. That's why I go on vacation, so I can be outside all the time.
Mm-hmm.
Basically,
the overabundance that's available in our culture helps us lead unhealthier lives.
Right. So in terms of obesity and vitamin D, one of the biggest things to remember is if you're overweight, you need more vitamin D. And that will help you burn your calories off. It stimulates the metabolism of sugar into energy, so you'll feel better.
So vitamin D helps get the cells to process the sugar in the nutrients that we eat.
Mm-hmm.
And if you don't have enough vitamin D, they don't trigger the cells to do that. That sugar then turns into fat and you get heavier.
Right.
And so it's just a
It makes you insulin
cycle.
Resistant. And it also, if you don't have enough vitamin D, you get insulin resistant and then diabetic eventually if you don't do something about it. And you also become obese.
Right.
If you have, it also affects your pancreas and it allows your body to have inappropriate secretions of insulin, which also play into this insulin resistance obesity scene.
So our recommendations are, with qualifiers, get outside more without sunscreen and covered clothing as much as you can safely do so, at least 20 to 30 minutes a day if you can. Supplement your diet with vitamin D, supplement your diet with Iodorol, and maximize your opportunity to live a longer, healthier life.
Thanks for listening to us.
Email your questions or comments to podcast@biobalancehealth.com. You can find the BioBalance HealthCast on iTunes and on YouTube. For more information about bioidentical hormone pellet therapy and other reverse aging solutions, visit biobalancehealth.com or call 314-993-0963. You can find Dr. Maupin on Twitter at Dr. Kathy Maupin and on Facebook at facebook.com/biobalancehealth. Find Brett Newcomb at brettnewcomb.com.